Alrighty, everybody, welcome back into the garage. Today we are doing another crazy little project, and that is strapping a 440cc snowmobile engine onto our little homemade motorcycle. Here is the heart of our project. It is the 440cc snowmobile engine. I bought the snowmobile off of Facebook. We don't get a lot of snowmobiles around where I live, so it was pretty unique, and I had to take the opportunity to buy it. So as you can see, we have the monstrosity on the motorcycle, and it looks dangerous, it looks crazy, and it looks awesome. So let me take you to the other side and show you what I have to do next.
So I have to line up the chain first before I can weld on the engine mount. And before I can line up the chain, I have to make a support for this side of this shaft here. So what I think I'm gonna do is get some cardboard and mock up kind of like a mount out of cardboard first, and then cut it out of some quarter inch steel plate.
So here is one side of the jack shaft. As you saw, I took this quarter inch steel and drilled a hole in it so that I can fit our shaft through, and then mounted a brand new bearing on the other side and fed it through. So the next thing I gotta do is merge the snowmobile part of the frame with the motorcycle. And I was thinking I could just kind of put these little plates of steel I got from the scrapyard, weld it, cut it, you know, and then kind of just do that all the way around. It's gonna take some time, but I think it'll look really cool once it's finished. guys, I just finished up the exhaust, finished up some of the brakes, put on the oil reservoir. I did all kinds of stuff to it. It is time to test ride it. It's in the truck, ready to go. Oh, I'm excited. I'm also really scared, but let's try it out. Well, guys, a few things. First off, that is the most crazy thing I've ever built. Never owned a snowmobile. I've never owned a dirt bike like that. And I see why people do. That is one of the craziest things ever. Once you hit that power band, you just fly. And I could have easily gone past 65 miles an hour. On a completely homemade motorcycle, 65 is more than good enough for me. I don't think I want to go any faster than that. A few things. That carburetor definitely needs a tune-up. The shroud was hitting the side of the motorcycle for a little bit, so I had to bend it up. I'm working on getting some stock brakes for it. Maybe some front disc brakes, rear disc brakes on the actual wheel, not on the jack shaft, because I know some of you are gonna hate that. On that note, I appreciate you watching. Be sure to like this video. It took more effort than I expected it to. So yeah, subscribe, like, do all that good stuff. Leave a comment on what you thought, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out.